7701, return to the incident command post.
We are located in Lyons, Oregon, which is about 20 miles east of Salem. So my name is Joshua Van Vlack. I'm the pastor here at Canyon Bible Fellowship. Most of the fires were north and east of us. It was the Beachie Creek Fire that impacted our area, and we're thankful that the Sandium River stopped the southward movement of the fire largely. I think we've heard upwards of 300 homes here in the canyon that were lost due to the fire. That doesn't include businesses and other outbuildings and things like that. Our church was impacted by the fire, not our physical facility, but we were evacuated the day after Labor Day. We saw this orange glow, and initially we thought it was the reflection of the city lights of Mill City, but we realized pretty quickly that it was the fires, and the wind had blown the fires down off of the foothills of the Cascades down into our canyon here. One of the great blessings of it all was with COVID, we had already started a digital prayer chain, a text group for prayers. Well, people were using that just to check on everybody else. I had a pretty good idea where every member of my congregation was, that they had evacuated safely and that they were all doing well. The fact that we were not significantly impacted really freed us up in terms of our ability to be able to look at opportunities for touching others who had been. And one of the things that we had been able to do was to go to John Neal Park, which is just less than a mile from our church here. And there were some people who really had been living on the margins anyway, economically. Some were homeless, some were borderline homeless, who had to evacuate. And we started a ministry where we provided a meal on Tuesday evenings, a pizza, and to be able to just be a blessing to them. We provided clothes, we provided blankets, we provided tarps when it was raining. It's small ways in a lot of cases, but we've really been thankful that God has enabled us to use what has happened, the challenging circumstances we experienced in September, as an opportunity for us to engage in ministry in a way that we would never have even looked into before. We did receive a fair amount of resources from the CV Northwest Fire Relief Fund, and we really appreciate that. When we got it, to be honest with you, we were a bit overwhelmed in a positive sense with how much we'd been blessed with. And so when we received that, one of the first steps we took was to put together a committee made up of some members of our congregation. Our prayer is that we can use these resources to help people in need in such a way that we're able to build ongoing relationships with those people. We understand that there's going to be some needs that will come up. People who have been impacted by fires, who either their insurance was not sufficient to meet all of their needs. One family that we were already in contact with that lost a lot of buildings and lost a home that had been built in the late 1880s. Things don't exactly move at the pace or in the way that you think they're going to move. And so things have been moving a little bit slower. We haven't really received a lot of the information that we had thought we were going to receive. Right at the outset, you think, okay, we've got this great opportunity to help with cleanup and help with a lot of this stuff. But a fire really, with all that comes with it, really puts a little bit of a different perspective on that. Please be praying for us that God would really open up opportunities for us to connect with people. We're constantly looking for new opportunities, and that we would be patient with the process, that we would allow God to lead us, and that more than anything, that we would be good stewards of the resources that we've been given, because we're so appreciative of the care and concern that people have expressed by giving. We want to honor those who have given, and we want to honor God with what we've been given as well. But bottom line, we are very thankful to be a part of this family, this covenant community. We really appreciate the connections that we've made within our church family and within our community in the aftermath of this. So we really thank everybody who has given to help out with this.